立法會主席
The President
Tou Kan Sun
Mr. James Tou under Rule 16.2 moved a motion. The wording has been tabled, and it says that the council shall adjourn to discuss the MPCSC's interpretation on the Hong Kong, the basic law of Hong Kong in relation to the matter of administration of oath an affirmation by LegCo. And in the letter, Mr. James Tou said that the interpretation will affect a judicial review case that will be heard tomorrow. And someone from the source said that it is inevitable that there will be an MPCSC interpretation. It shows that Mr. James Tou's motion is related, is based on a press report and not facts. So there is no need for it to be debated today. So I will not approve Mr. James Tou's request. Mr. Tou? The chief executive said that he cancelled the Beijing trip to deal with the administration of oaths and affirmation in Hong Kong, and he also said that he would not rule out the possibility of an interpretation. And I think it has reflected the possibility. So shouldn't you talk to the source that is close to the government, and also what CY Leung said? I mean, you should have taken them into consideration. I heard yesterday from the Secretary for Justice that this will be dealt with in the Hong Kong judicial system. Since it's not based on facts, I cannot approve your request under 16.2. Mr. Charles Mok. However, CY Leung said himself that he would not rule out the possibility of an interpretation of the basic law. So is it the case that Mr. James Tou's wording said that the MPCSC would or will do it, that's why you did not allow it? So if it says that CY Leung doesn't rule the possibility of an interpretation and it may affect the court case, then will you reconsider? What if we change the wording to direct it at CY Leung? Would you deal with it? I've already made a ruling, and in fact all motions will have to be based on facts. Not ruling out the possibility is not a fact. It's not something that will be done, so I will not allow it. Mr. Holden Chow, President, but at a point of order, I agree with your ruling, and I would like to draw your attention to 41 sub rule 2. That is in relation to cases. Mr. Chow, this is not a point of order. Please sit down. Well, we should not discuss a case here, Ms. Claudia Mo. My understanding is that you talk about facts that has happened, and we can move a motion. But we're talking about important public interest. What if I write a letter to change the wording to concern? Will you allow it? My ruling has been made. Well, what if I submit a letter to you from afresh? It's not subject to debate.
What? Hi, Leung Yew Chung.
Mr. Leung Yew Chung. President, you said Mr. Tou's remarks
on Mr. C.Y. Leung's saying, and then you said that it was just media reports. But then you have quoted some other remarks or report that the Mr. Rimsky Yun said that the matter can be resolved within the Hong Kong's legal system. So is Mr. Yun's remarks more trustworthy or Mr. C.Y. Leung's remarks more trustworthy? Because you've quoted the comments from the Secretary for Justice. Well, the Secretary for Justice spoke in front of myself, and he also said the same in front of the media. Well, the C.Y. Leung said that he didn't rule out. So, my ruling cannot be debated. Now, if you don't understand it, you may debate it or talk about it at some other occasions. You can discuss this at some other occasions with me. If you don't understand it, well, please talk to me at some other occasions. Mr. Andrew Wan. Well, this is not a point of order. Well, can I finish first? This is not a Q&A session. If you are on a point of order, point out specifically which point of order. Now you've made the ruling. I hope maybe later on in the day when we provide you with more information showing that it's not purely speculation, can you consider it? Well, please take your seat. Questions?